would like to take this opportunity to say that I love LiveJournal. Which is a little odd because LiveJournal really hit its heyday back in, 2003, 2004. And it's not really a surprise given that you all know I have this obsession with fanfiction, and LiveJournal communities are pretty much the best place to get fanfiction these days. But sometimes fandom is amazing. A couple weeks ago I wrote this fic about John Watson being a knitter, and it's been received very well by the Sherlock fanfic fandom over on LiveJournal, which is nice. It's been recommended a couple of times, actually, which is unusual for anything of mine. But this isn't about the fic itself. It's about the author's note on the fic where I said I wished that Sherlock would lose his frackin' scarf so that he can get a proper knit one so I can make a replica of it. And LiveJournal user Brienne's, who just found my fic the other day, left a comment giving me a stitch and an approximate weight of yarn in which I could possibly make a Sherlock scarf replica without him having to lose his scarf and get a fracking knit one. My life might be complete right now. Granted, I can't actually start on this scarf for a while because I have other projects to do right now, but I could very well be making Sherlock scarves. That makes me very happy indeed. That was part one, by the way. This is part two. Tea obsession. Now, you all know I like to get my siblings obsessed with the same things that I'm obsessed with, which works remarkably well because when we're all in the same space, we're the same person, basically. So, I get them obsessed with things that I'm obsessed with all the time. They get me obsessed with things that they're obsessed with all the time. It's a system that works. Last week, Pickleface started drinking tea, and he's become a tea fiend. So much so that Saturday, as it was snowing and a little bit icing outside, I was preparing to go to the post office because I needed to mail something that somebody had bought from my Etsy store, and going to the bank, because I wouldn't have another chance to do it if it kept snowing and a little bit icing. He did a tea count, in which we determined there were only a handful of regular decaf tea bags left, and he had just finished the lemon zinger, and I had finished the mandarin orange spice before, and we had two left of the pomegranate black tea, and I have English breakfast loose leaf tea, which I can survive on, but it's caffeinated. So I only drink it occasionally, and he's not going to drink it at all because he's 14. He doesn't need to be hooked on caffeine that early. He looked a little worried, and he asked if I could stop off at IGA and just pick up some tea while I was out in the snow. I have no doubt in my mind that if he had a license and a vehicle in which to drive, he would have gone to the store and stocked up on tea himself, which I find hilarious. And finally, part three of the theme for this week, which is your favorite thing about being a scout. And my favorite thing about being a scout was camping. We went camping every year, sometimes twice a year, depending on the year, since I was in the second grade-ish, second, third grade. And I was a scout until I graduated high school. And I really miss it. I mean, I love the hiking around in the woods, and I love the smell of frozen dawn, because it was always cold when we went. It didn't matter what month it was, it was going to be freezing because we were sleeping outside. There has been at least one time where it snowed. So frozen dawn is like the best thing ever to wake up to, and the smell of fire, and it's just so good. Honestly, it's one of the reasons why I stayed so long. Okay, I think I've covered everything I need to cover in this video. This cat is making it a practice to be in this room every time I film a video. I think it is that he hears me talking, and he assumes that I'm reading something aloud. He likes to listen to me read books, the same way you guys like to listen to me read fanfic, because it puts him to sleep, and he likes to sleep. So he comes in here and falls asleep to the sound of my voice. So I think that's why he comes in here whenever I start filming. But enough about my cat, this video should really end. So, Lindsay, I will see you on Wednesday, and Lainey, I will see you on Friday.